Robert Ingebrigtsen. When I was on the spinach, I was a TM2. I spent 4 years on the hammerhead then, operating out of the Atlantic, one Mediterranean, one northern run, for 90 days up north and stuff like that. New style, especially for me. Coming off diesel boats where you had one hull or one deck, or blueback, of course, they had a one main deck inside, but it was a raised deck for up around the Harrisburg area. But hammerhead, I went aboard there and they said, well, we're going to be leaving for a northern run here in 2 weeks. And I went aboard there, and you go down ladders, and first you're going facing aft, and then you're facing forward, and the torpedo room, of course, all the way down in the center of that particular submarine, a 637 class fast attack. And first few days, I wasn't really sure which way I was pointed once I got all the way down there. But I knew the torpedo tubes always had to face forward, so I could use those for get orientated where I was at and stuff like that. But again, I was a first class torpedo man when I first went to the hammerhead. I made chief torpedo man on there, and we made one northern run. We had a major overhaul at Newport News, where we did a reactor change and overhauled all of our equipment at Newport News. And then coming out of there, we went to the Mediterranean for operating in the Mediterranean. But an interesting thing on the hammerhead, we got to watch a Russian Christmas party in the Mediterranean. On the flight deck of one of their aircraft carriers. That was always something to envision while they brought in their submarines, tied it up to a ship, and then everybody was up on their flight deck having a Christmas party up there. So, of course, we were taking pictures and recording, but it was interesting. We were always chasing them. We'd be listening and all that, running back and forth across the Med as fast as we could, trying to catch them. If we got them, then we'd tail them and record our screw noises, ship's noises, evolutions that they did, and take pictures and stuff like that, underhaul pictures if we could get them, and take them back to archive. We had, like I said, that encounter. Can't say that we ever were chased by one, or that, to my knowledge, I ever knew if we got caught or whatever. But a lot of times, what happens between sonar and the captain or whatever is privileged information for them, and not necessarily brought down to the rest of it. Although we could pretty much follow everything that was going on by daily updates and stuff like that, where we were going and stuff like that. I guess I was 7 months, something like that. I got transferred off while we were in the Mediterranean. Their last stop at there to go to my next duty station, which was Crown Subgroup 6.